So hi everyone, this is Prateek Bhayia and I'm really glad to welcome you all to the webinar on how to kickstart coding. So a lot of students were requesting, Bhaiya, humne JEE ka exam diya hai, ab hum kya karein, summer vacation hai, free hai, ya college mein first year mein kaise progress karein, ya Google mein job leni hai, to hume kya karna padega, right? So is type ki bahut sari queries mere paas thi, to maine socha kyun na webinar karein, and jab maine webinar ke liye registrations liye, so I have received over 1000 responses and 500 plus questions from all of you, right? So sabhi questions to main aaj nahi le paunga, but most jo common questions hai unki main baat karunga. I will guide you ki kaise aapko first year mein ya JEE ke baad aapko kya steps lene hain, so that you become a great programmer and you end up in a great job or a startup, right? So सबसे पहले मेरा सबको वेलकम एंड आई वेलकम ऑल माई जूनियर्स फ्रेंड्स जो भी इस वेबिनार को देख रहे हैं. सो हेलो टू एवरी वन एंड आई सी मोर पीपल आर ज्वाइनिंग, राइट? सो कुछ लोग नए भी होंगे जो मेरा फर्स्ट वेबिनार देख रहे होंगे, एंड आई एम प्रतीक नारंग. सो पीपल कॉल मी प्रतीक भैया बिकॉज टाइम टू टाइम मैं उनको गाइड करता रहता हूँ. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो कॉल मी भैया, राइट? And I basically teach programming at coding blocks. I take offline courses, I take online courses, and I work with ML, deep learning, algorithms, game development, couple of fields altogether. And my aim is to make people fall in love with coding, right? Because programming is awesome. You can make anything with code, and I try to teach in such a manner that most of you will fall in love with coding. So not me, it's the philosophy of coding blocks, so that once you are fallen in love with coding, you are passionate about your work, you can do wonders in your job or in your startup or in your own venture, right? So that's the whole idea. So we want to make people who are passionate about programming, right? So this is, and I will describe my journey first. So like you people have given the JEE exam, and I also appeared for JEE exam when I was in school in 2012, and then in college I learned about some skills. I made my small website which got pretty famous by the name of interactive resume, right? So it's on prateeknarang.com, and I'm just going to show you so that you guys also feel motivated to do things in your career or in your life, right? So this is my Mario style resume, and this got viewed in over 120 countries. So I belong to Jalandhar, Punjab. I did my schooling. I got good grades in class 10th, 12th, and good rank in JEE. And then I got into DTU, and later on last year I joined IIT Delhi for my master's in machine learning. And I learned couple of programming languages during the college, right? So remember, मेरे को first year में भी programming नहीं आती थी, मैंने 11th 12th में भी नहीं की थी. First year में मेरे को हल्का फुल्का जो college syllabus था, then तो second year वो time था when I started programming. But at that time and at the current stage, the awareness among the students has increased a lot. So you cannot wait for your second year to come to start programming. So this is the time कि आप JEE से free हो गए हो, you have to start working, right? So I learned couple of skills like HTML, JS, Python, Django, Android Dev, and designing का मेरे को शुरू से interest था. From my class 8, I was quite inclined towards designing art, games, and all that stuff. So using all those skills, using programming, using the concepts of game development, using graphic designing, I made this interactive resume. And I did couple of internships like at HackerEd, SanDisk. Then I joined Coding Blocks as a instructor and a founding member, right? So these are some of the projects I worked during my internships and college projects. And there are hackathons and competitions being organized throughout the year, right? So जो लोग first year में जा रहे हैं देखेंगे कि कभी कोई हैकाथॉन आ रहा है, कभी कोई कंपटीशन आ रहा है, इवेंट आ रहा है, तो मैं सजेस्ट करूंगा डू टेक पार्ट इन देम, इवन इफ यू नो लेस, बट टेकिंग पार्ट आल्सो हेल्प यू टू लर्न लॉट ऑफ स्किल्स. सो आपका एक पीयर ग्रुप बन जाता है, मे बी आप टीम में कुछ अच्छा बना सकते हैं. सो सिमिलरली आई वॉन अ गूगल हैकाथॉन, CSI हैकाथॉन, कोड डेली हैकाथॉन, देन दीज डेज गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज कंडक्टिंग स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथॉन. सो उसमें भी आप पार्ट ले सकते हैं, एंड इट्स conducted at a very large scale, so that's a good achievement if you add to your resume, right? Then there is a competitive programming competition at international level, which is called ACM-ICPC. जो लोग फर्स्ट ईयर में जा रहे हैं उनको नहीं पता होगा, बट कॉलेज में जाओगे तो दिस इज अ कॉम्पिटिशन विच इज यू कैन से द ग्रेटेस्ट कॉम्पिटिशन इन कॉम्पिटेटिव प्रोग्रामिंग एंड इट इज ऑर्गेनाइज थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड. सो इंडिया के जो बेस्ट लोग होते हैं दे गो इन टू द वर्ल्ड फाइनल्स, राइट? देन सम ऑफ माई एक्टिविटीज एंड हॉबीज एंड दीज आर माई रिज्यूमे, राइट? सो वेन यू आर इन गोइंग इन टू कॉलेज मेक श्योर यू आर एक्टिव ऑन वेरियस वेबसाइट्स लाइक गिटहब. So GitHub is your like live resume. So जो भी आप काम कर रहे हो it will reflect कि आपने throughout the year how much time you have spent coding, right? So this is my GitHub profile. So these green dot basically shows on which days I was active on GitHub and I was pushing my codes to GitHub, right? So if someone is going to hire you, then he's also going to see how consistent you are and how much contribution you are making to open source and what all projects you have done and what amount of code you have written, right? So all those stats are given by GitHub, right? So if you're going for an interview and if you say, okay, one day before I will make my resume and I will make my GitHub profile, that is not going to help, right? So to have a very good profile, you have to be active throughout the year, right? So I will talk about GitHub maybe in some other webinar also, and there is a webinar by Arnav which basically teaches you how to work with GitHub. So it is a version control system. For example, you are working on a project and you want to maintain a history. What changes you made during couple of days or during the entire year. So it keeps track of everything, right? So Git is a version control system and GitHub is a collaborative platform where you can share and host your projects and also find code of what others are doing, right? So pretty cool. And so you got a basic idea about my journey, and now I will come to the agenda of today's webinar. So let me just click this. So as I said, today we are going to talk about computer science, some cool applications and domains in computer science, which programming languages you should choose if you are going to start, and what should be the roadmap of a first year student who wants to get a very good job at the end of its third year or fourth year, and maybe you want to start make your own startup, right? And many people had asked me how to crack jobs at companies like Google. So sabka jo roadmap hai, I will discuss, and as your bhaiya, I'm going to give you some advice and suggestions. So let's start, right? So I know आज बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग भी होंगे जिन्होंने सोचा होगा JEE mains के बाद हम JEE main 2 में अच्छा perform करेंगे, but somehow maybe आपका JEE mains 1 or 2 as expected नहीं गया होगा, right? So don't worry, आपका time अभी भी है, you have not lost anything. अभी सिर्फ थोड़ा सा college में आपका difference आएगा, but if you learn the right skills and right time, which is your college years, you can also end up at a very good job in Microsoft or Amazon or Google or something like that, right? The only thing these companies are going to need is the right skills, right? So you go to hackathons, win competitions, build projects, make a good profile in competitive coding, and definitely you can end up getting a good job or whatever you want to be, right? So आपका टाइम आएगा, डोंट वरी, एंड यू कैन स्टिल डू इट, राइट? सो कीप योर स्पिरिट हाई, कीप योर सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड, एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? बिकॉज आई सीन सम पीपल गेट डिप्रेस्ड इन द फर्स्ट ईयर कि हमारा JEE अच्छा नहीं आया, हम दोबारा देंगे नेक्स्ट ईयर, ये दे रिपीट द सेम साइकिल. सो कीप योर सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड. अगर आपको लगता है कि यू कैन डू much better in JEE और इस साल आप नहीं कर पाए तो ड्रॉप अप करो, बट इफ यू आर थिंकिंग कि मैंने कॉलेज ज्वाइन करना है, देन डू नॉट ट्राई टू थिंक कि मैं ड्रॉप भी करूँगा, मैं JEE भी करूँगा, मैं कोडिंग भी करूँगा. तो इतनी सारी चीज़ें आपकी बैलेंस नहीं हो पाएंगे, राइट? तो अगर इफ यू मेड अ डिसीजन टू ज्वाइन अ डिसेंट कॉलेज, मेक श्योर यू वर्क वेरी हार्ड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑन द राइट स्किल्स, राइट? सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, राइट? बट फर्स्ट ईयर में करना क्या, राइट? सो आप जाओगे, दो साल आपने पढ़ाई की है तो सब बोल रहे होंगे यार बेटा दो साल पढ़ ले, उसके बाद कॉलेज में तो ऐश ही करनी है, ठीक है? तो कॉलेज में जाके बहुत सारे लोग फर्स्ट ईयर में ही सोचते हैं यार 2 साल पढ़ के आए, अब ठीक है थोड़ा रिलैक्स करेंगे, मस्ती करेंगे, मूवीज देखेंगे, शोज देखेंगे, राइट? तो दे गेट इन टू टीवी शोज, सीरीज, गेम्स, वर्ल्ड कप आ रहा है, ठीक है, इन सब की बात आप आपके दोस्तों से देखना कर रहे होंगे, बट कुछ लोग होंगे जो सुपर उस पर होंगे, वो अपने रूम में घुसे रहेंगे एंड दे वुड बी टाइपिंग समथिंग ऑन योर ऑन दैट ब्लैक स्क्रीन. सो दोज आर कोडर्स, राइट? तो आप देख लो आपको कौन सी कैटेगरी में रहना है, मौज मस्ती करनी है, देन यू विल रिग्रेट लेटर कि यार फर्स्ट ईयर में क्यों नहीं पढ़े, फर्स्ट ईयर में हमारे मार्क्स कम क्यों हो गए, राइट? तो फर्स्ट ईयर से हैबिट डाल लो, कोडिंग की हैबिट डालोगे, यू विल बी कोडिंग थ्रू आउट द 4 ईयर्स. इफ यू मेक अ हैबिट ऑफ वॉचिंग टीवी शो सीरीज, देन इसी की आदत लग जाएगी एंड इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू गेट अवे फ्रॉम इट, राइट? तो आई नो बहुत सारे लोगों का करियर इस वजह से नहीं बन पाया कि उन्होंने 3 साल खराब कर दिए अपने टीवी शोज वगैरह देखने में, जब प्लेसमेंट आई तो पढ़ना स्टार्ट कर दिया. तो ऐसे नहीं होता है, यू हैव टू बी वेरी कंसिस्टेंट इन योर एफर्ट्स, राइट? तो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप फर्स्ट ईयर से बैलेंस बना के चलो, ठीक है, मूवीज, स्पोर्ट्स, टीवी शोज इंपॉर्टेंट है, बट गिव देम अ लिमिटेड टाइम, मेक अ शेड्यूल कि मैं कोडिंग में इतना टाइम स्पेंड करूंगा, हर हफ्ते में अगर मैंने 14 आवर्स डिवोट करने तो करने हैं, राइट? एंड मे बी महीने में एक बार मूवी देखने जा सकते हो, राइट? बट ये नहीं होना चाहिए कि 7 दिन मूवी देख रहे हो और 1 दिन कोडिंग कर रहे हो, दैट्स नॉट द राइट वे टू डू इन द फर्स्ट ईयर, राइट, और इन सेकेंड ईयर, राइट? सो डू नॉट स्पेंड टू मच टाइम ऑन टीवी शोज एंड मूवीज, ऑल दैट स्टफ, एंड वॉट यू नीड इज द स्किल्स. सो मेक योर सेल्फ रेडी टू अडॉप्ट न्यू स्किल्स जहाँ से भी सीखने को मिल रहा है, राइट? कॉलेज में सोसाइटीज होंगी जो कुछ सेशंस ले रही होंगी, उनसे आपको कुछ सीखने को मिल सकता है, वो देखो, या सीनियर्स कोई वर्कशॉप लगा रहे हैं उसमें जाओ, ठीक है? तो आइडिया इज यू यूटिलाइज योर टाइम एंड लर्न न्यू स्किल्स, एंड बिलीव मी जो कॉलेज में आपको लैब्स होंगी या प्रोफेसर्स होंगे, डू नॉट एक्सपेक्ट लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स फ्रॉम देम, राइट? सो दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू हेल्प यू. फर्स्ट ईयर में लगेगा अच्छा सेकंड ईयर में कोड कराएंगे कॉलेज वाले, नहीं. सेकंड ईयर में लगेगा थर्ड ईयर में हमें कुछ अच्छा कराएंगे, नहीं. थर्ड ईयर में लगेगा अच्छा अब तो फाइनल ईयर, अब तो कोई प्रोजेक्ट बनेगा हमारा, मशीन लर्निंग ये आएगा, नहीं. कुछ नहीं होने वाला है, सब कुछ आपको खुद से करना है, अनलेस यू आर इन IITs, वहां पे इतना प्रेशर होगा कि यू वुड बी वर्किंग ऑन सम गुड प्रोजेक्ट्स, बट इफ यू आर इन सम अदर कॉलेज, आई डोंट थिंक देर इज गोइंग टू बी एनी सच प्रेशर फ्रॉम द कॉलेज अथॉरिटीज कि आपको कोडिंग अच्छी करनी है. सो यू हैव टू कीप योर सेल्फ मोटिवेटेड कि कोडिंग बहुत अच्छी करनी है हमें, एंड यू हैव टू स्टैंड आउट फ्रॉम द क्राउड. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड कंप्यूटर साइंस एक ऐसी ब्रांच है दैट इज नॉट वेरी ओल्ड, अभी अगर 20 साल पहले चले जाओ एंड देर वॉज मोर स्कोप ऑफ मैकेनिकल एंड सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, बट इंटरनेट आने की वजह से, डेटा आने की वजह से, इतने सारे कंप्यूटर में एल्गोरिदम्स, हार्डवेयर, न्यू डिवाइसेस आने की वजह से कंप्यूटर साइंस इज ऑन अ एक्सपोनेंशियल राइज एंड इट इज गोइंग टू इट इज हेयर टू स्टे, राइट? सो मेनी एक्साइटिंग फील्ड्स एंड या सो डोमेन्स आर देयर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड न्यू प्रोडक्ट्स एंड सर्विसेज आर कमिंग एवरी डे. सो पुराने जमाने में लोग चिट्ठी लिखते थे एंड वो बहुत टाइम लगता था पहुंचने में, आजकल यू हैव अ व्हाट्सएप, 1 सेकेंड में मैसेज पहुंच जाता है, राइट? कहीं जाना है सो यू बुक ऊबर ऑन योर फोन एंड इट कम्स टू योर प्लेस. किसी से बात करनी है, फोटो डालनी है, तो यू हैव फेसबुक, इंस्टाग्राम, किसी को पैसे भेजने, यू हैव पेटीएम, तो एवरीथिंग इज ऑन योर मोबाइल, राइट? सो मोबाइल डिजिटल इंडिया, डिजिटल वर्ल्ड का जमाना है, सो एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग टू हैपन थ्रू योर कंप्यूटर, राइट? एंड मोबाइल इज ऑल्सो कंप्यूटर, राइट? उसके अलावा न्यू डिवाइसेज, न्यू वेरिएबल्स आ गए हैं. सो आजकल, पहले अगर मेरे को अलार्म लगाना होता था तो आई चेक माई फोन, आई फाइंड आउट कि यार वेर इज द ऐप, सेट दिस टाइम, एंड उस फोन को मैं रख देता था. नाउ यू हैव एलेक्सा, ओके? सो एलेक्सा सेट अ रिमाइंडर फॉर 7 AM. सो आप वॉइस से सारा कुछ कर रहे हो, सही? तो वॉइस इज ब्रिंगिंग अ न्यू रेवोल्यूशन, राइट? सो यू हैव IoT डिवाइसेज, यू हैव होम ऑटोमेशन सिस्टम्स, यू हैव स्मार्ट बैंड्स, फिटबिट्स, लॉट ऑफ न्यू गैजेट्स एंड टेक्निकल इन्वेंशंस आर कमिंग अप विच इज गोइंग टू मेक लाइफ ईजी फॉर अस. एंड विद द एडवेंट ऑफ न्यू हार्डवेयर, न्यू डिवाइसेज, न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी, देर इज अ रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ मोर सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर्स, मोर नंबर ऑफ एप्स, मोर नंबर ऑफ यूजर्स ऑल्सो, राइट? सो एंड लॉट ऑफ कंपनीज आर कमिंग इन द ML एंड द AI डोमेन, स्मार्ट होम्स, स्मार्ट कार्स, स्मार्ट न्यूज रीडर्स, देर आर स्मार्ट वेटर्स इन द रेस्टोरेंट्स दैट कमिंग अप, सो दे विल बी सर्विंग फूड टू यू ऑन योर सीट, राइट? सो रोबोट्स आर गोइंग टू डू लॉट ऑफ वर्क लाइक क्लीनिंग, सर्विंग फूड, टॉकिंग टू यू एंड स्पीकिंग न्यूज ऑल्सो, राइट? lot of things are coming up, and ML is going to suggest you what to eat, right? So you ask Google, okay, what are the some good food options nearby? It tells you what to wear. So Microsoft is working on a Bing fashion recommendation system, which basically suggests you what kind of trouser you should wear with this kind of a cloth, right? So they have some complimentary fashion recommendation system. Where to go? Okay, so you get suggestions. What are some cool places to hang out with your friends? You get your reminders that you have a flight on this day, this time from Google. And there is a email autocomplete feature. Recently, I was typing my mail and I saw this feature, Smart Compose, right? It basically not only completes the word, it also completes what you are thinking. So pretty cool application, right? So what you are thinking in your brain is basically completed by Google. So you are saving a lot of time in typing emails on your mobile, right? So there is a technology called language modeling in deep learning behind that, which we will not talk about today, but there are cool things which you can learn while in your college, right? So you can, maybe this could be your college project, right? So you can make something like this, and this basically for a few days it notes what kind of patterns or what kinds of English you are going to type, and then it recognizes, okay, you are going this kind of work, right? So this is your typing pattern, right? So it finds out some cool interesting patterns, and then it completes what you are going to think. So a lot of cool application, right? And the good thing about computer science is you have highest number of jobs available at the present and in future. You have great pay packages starting from 5 to 10 lakhs. You can end up as getting 30 to 40 lakhs as a fresher, right? And there are a lot of startups coming up. You can join them. There are new devices and gadgets. Maybe you can use your skills to work on hardware and software both, or you can start your own venture, right? And new devices, gadgets, as I said, are coming up. IoT is coming up, Internet of Things, and a lot of product based companies are also coming up, like Ola, Uber, Paytm, right? So all these companies are going to have something for you, right? So you can definitely choose computer science as a very safe option and with a very bright career perspective, right? So even if you're not getting CS or you're getting a related field, definitely you should pick it up. And there are people who are in EC and they want to do coding, or you are in mechanical or civil, you want to go coding. So you guys can also learn, right? So if you're not getting a relevant branch in your college, but you want to go into computer science, you can learn those skills as well, right? Okay, so let's talk about what does a computer engineer do, right? So this is a pretty famous joke about it, that what my friends think I do, so, and what my mother thinks I do, and what society thinks I do, but actually I am playing games, right? So although this is jokes apart, right? So this is a joke, and what actually computer scientists do. So there are multiple roles for a computer engineer, right? So one very common role that companies offers is a software developer, right? So the goal, job of the software developer is to write some simple algorithms and code them and build some functionality. For example, you are building a ticket booking system for a Paytm app, right? So then you have to think of logic that how should I allot a particular seat to a particular person, right? Or there are people who have requested a lower berth and these many upper berths are available. Then how should I allot these people according to their preference? This kind of logic you have to code, and this is the job of a software developer, right? And this is one example, okay? So web developer basically, so web is a pretty large area and it includes two components. One is backend. So for example, you are opening up your Facebook on your mobile. So what you see on your mobile is a mobile web app or an Android app, but you are making some requests to the server, which is the Facebook server, and you are requesting some data from it. So there are some algorithms which are running on your server, and suppose you want to see who all are there in my friend list. There is a function, get friends, which basically brings you all those friends, right? So that part which is running on the server is comes under backend, and the front part which basically you see on your screen is the UI part or the front end part. Right? So if you want to be a web developer, you need to have some knowledge of backend, some knowledge of front end, some knowledge of user interface, right? And there is another kind of a role called UI UX developer. Right? So UI is basically what you see, and UX is basically how the flow should be. For example, I want to make a shopping website, and one website takes 10 clicks to buy one product and another website takes 3 clicks to buy that product. So we will say the second website has a better UX, which basically means the flow of control is very smooth and you are improving the user experience. So if you are creative, if you have interest in designing and you have some good creativity, you can definitely check out this role, and you can also do work as a freelancer, right? And another role is data analyst. So you get to work with huge amounts of data. For that, you need some mathematical knowledge, some statistical knowledge, some concepts of probability. And then there is a job role called data scientist, then which also involves your analytics skills, coding skills, mathematical skills, critical thinking, logical reasoning also. And in that, you may be employed as a machine learning or a deep learning engineer, right? So you need how to write good quality code, and you need to work with some advanced algorithms also, right? And mobile app developer, so there are requirements for a lot of product-based companies like Paytm, Zomato, Swiggy. They all have their apps. So you can be a mobile developer, and you would be basically working with how to get data from the server or how to write code in Swift or in Java or in Kotlin for Android and iOS type of devices, right? So these are some roles. And what are the skills that most companies would be expecting when you graduate from your college, right? So they will expect you have strong fundamentals, you have logical thinking, you are able to analyze a problem statement and think a solution for it, right? And you should be able to write clean code in languages like C++, Java, or Python. And you have some hands-on experience on working on some projects, maybe during your internships or during your college. So some of the languages you can pick is Node.js for backends, JavaScript for your front-end part, and languages like Python, which are also very popular and powerful, right? But there are certain companies which expect something more out of you, right? So there are companies like Google, Facebook, which will also expect that you have a very strong hand in competitive programming, because these big companies work on large amounts of data, right? And if you want efficient computation on that data, you need efficient algorithms, and this is where competitive programming comes into picture, right? So you need to start with some language which gives you a fairly good idea of how computers work and how you can interact with the computer, right? So the goal of the programming language is to communicate your instructions to the computer so that computer can do something for you, right? So you can start with a programming language like C++ or Java. You master data structures and algorithms. So DS algorithms is basically, so data structures are containers which basically help you to store data. For example, you want to make an application which basically tells you what is the shortest path from Delhi to Mumbai, and you want to get some roadmap, right? So you need to store what all roads are there, what all landmarks are there, and how should you drive the car. So data is stored in a container called a data structure, and for this problem you might use a graph data structure. And algorithm is a logic according to which you drive your car, right? So that is what these companies expect, that given a problem you should be able to find out what is the most relevant data structure and what algorithm you will implement and to solve this problem, right? And then you have to be very good at competitive programming, because they want the solutions should be optimized, right? So your algorithm should run in very less amount of time, and you should be focusing more on competitive programming. For example, if you only complete this path, right, Like you do C++, Java, you do DSL, you do competitive, and then you can also end up into a company like Google, right? But some people, what they do, they also learn some more programming languages like Python, JS, and depending on their interest, they go into web or machine learning or Android. And then maybe you can come back to the competitive programming before your interviews, and then you can join that company, right? So the most important part for companies like Google, Facebook is the competitive programming. They conduct their own challenges like Google Kickstart, Facebook Hacker Cup, and Code Jam, right? So these are very important competitions if you want to get into these type of companies, right? And another roadmap for product-based companies would be, if you're not good, very good at maths, or if you think that I'm not able to solve very complex competitive programming problems, you can try to learn some different technologies like Python, JS, and do some machine learning or web development, and then you can apply for that company, right? So you can skip this part. Okay, I'm not going to do competitive programming. My target is to target Amazon or Samsung or Flipkart or Adobe. These type of companies I want to do. Focus more on DS and Elgo part and build couple of projects in your resume, right? This is what these companies are going to expect. And if you have some good achievements, like maybe third position in a hackathon, that will also definitely add value to your resume, right? And what is the roadmap for a data scientist, ML engineer, deep learning engineer, or an AI engineer? Couple of companies like Google or YouTube or Baidu's, or these companies also hire people for their ML and the deep learning domain, right? So again, the prerequisite is very simple. You have to be you have some knowledge of C++ or Java, right? You should know the basics, the data structure and the algorithms, and then you should know some languages like Python or R for data analysis, and you should be familiar with the concepts of data science and how to build a couple of projects using machine learning and deep learning. And if you have some research papers or research internships, that would basically turn out to be helpful. And you have some certain qualifications, maybe you have some certifications in these courses, or you have done an MS or an PhD, then they are definitely going to consider you, right? So these are the important things that you should keep in mind for a roadmap if you want to be a data scientist or in a similar domain, right? And there is one more thing that many first years think of, they will become an ethical hacker, right? And what is the roadmap or how to learn ethical mapping? So let me clear you that ethical hacking, there is nothing such as ethical hacking, right? There is a large fraud going in the name of ethical hacking. They will teach you 5 or 10 or tricks which are quite outdated, and basically in order to hack a system, you should know how the system was built, right? So instead of wasting time on ethical hacking courses or workshops, learn about courses on networking, right? How a system is made, or system engineering courses, right? And spend some time on making a website or a web app in which you use authentication, work on projects, find out, okay, what is the loophole if I want to attack my own website? What are the things I can do? Look for security lapses, what are the possible vulnerabilities, and so on, right? So be a robust engineer, right? So I think do not get trapped into the ethical hacking thing. So a lot of first years, they get attracted towards these kinds of workshops, but let me clear you, this is something which is not going to take you forward, right? If you want to be a skilled engineer, if you want to be a hacker, or if you want to attack systems, you should know networking, system engineering, system design, web dev, automation. So authentication, lot of things you need to know, right? And next point is how to get these skills, right? There are a lot of websites, lot of free resources available on YouTube, lot of courses on Coursera, lot of on other websites, right? And there are also courses available on coding blocks, which are very detailed and exhaustive courses. Along with that, we also give you large number of questions to practice, right? So this is what sets us apart from other platforms. So we are also running these online programs, and you can definitely take a trial or look up at the course structure. So I'm not going to talk more about the Coding Blocks online platform, because this is something which should be your choice, right? How do you want to learn and where you want to learn, right? So you can take some online courses, you can take some offline courses, do peer practice, right? So if you're in hostels, a bahut bada advantage ye hota hai ki दोस्तों के साथ बैठ के यू कैन डिस्कस कि यार ये क्वेश्चन तेरा हो गया, मेरा नहीं हुआ, चल बता तूने क्या ट्रिक लगाई या मैंने क्या लगाया, राइट? या मेरा टीएलई आ रहा है, तेरा सही आ रहा है, तो व्हाट लॉजिक यू हैव लर्न, राइट? तो पीयर ग्रुप में बैठ के काफी अच्छी प्रैक्टिस आप कर सकते हो. तो कॉम्पिटिशन और हैकेथन्स में आप पार्ट ले सकते हो एंड हेल्प अदर्स. सो काफी कई लोगों को टीचिंग का शौक होता है. सो वेन यू टीच समवन यू ऑल्सो गेट टू लर्न न्यू थिंग्स, राइट? सो दैट इज वन वे टू इम्प्रूव योर स्किल्स. एंड फोकस ऑन क्वालिटी दैन क्वान्टिटी. की अगर आपको 10 क्वेश्चन करने को मिल रहे हैं और एक ही टाइप के हैं, इंस्टेड की दो क्वेश्चन कर लो, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट तरह के कर लो. एंड देर आर लॉट ऑफ वेबसाइट्स लाइक कोड फोर्सेज, हैकर रैंक, हैकर ब्लॉग्स. इन सब पे आपको डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, एल्गोरिथम, C++, जावा के बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन करने को मिल जाएंगे, राइट? एंड यू कैन डेफिनेटली चेक आउट अवर ओन प्लेटफॉर्म विच इज कोडिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑनलाइन. And it contains courses for almost all the topics we have discussed, starting from data structures, algorithms, machine learning. And believe me, more than 10,000 students have taken up these courses, and most of them are now at good companies like Amazon, Flipkart, Zomato, Samsung, and even Google too, right? So you can also benefit from these courses if you are interested. Definitely check out our website. So I'm not here to promote our own products, right? So this is one website which I would genuinely recommend to you to check out, right? So aisa nahi hai ki yaar hamare courses acche hain, aur bhi websites ho sakti hain jinke courses acche hon, but definitely if you take our course, I can assure you ki you will feel lot of satisfaction ki yaar mereko sara content ek hi proper स्ट्रक्चर में मिल रहे हैं. अगर आप यूट्यूब से कर रहे हो तो कंटेंट इज नॉट ऑर्गेनाइज्ड, राइट? सो कोई वीडियो कहाँ पड़ी है, कोई वीडियो कहाँ पड़ी है, एंड देर इज नॉट अ सिस्टमेटिक वे ऑफ लर्निंग. सो अगर आप कोडिंग ब्लॉक्स को चूज करते हो, यू विल गेट अ वेरी सिस्टमेटिक वे कि इस सेक्शन के बाद ओके, दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस आई हैव टू डू, दीज आर द क्विजेस आई हैव टू अटेम्प्ट, दीज आर द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन ऑफ वीडियोस, राइट? सो लॉट ऑफ कोर्सेज आर वेरी एग्जॉस्टिव कोर्सेज एंड दे विल टेक कपल ऑफ मंथ्स टू फिनिश, राइट? तो ऐसा नहीं है कि आप एक दिन में कोडर बन जाओगे. तो जैसे लोहा भी गर्म होता है, सो इट टेक्स टाइम, सो इसको बहुत सारा हीटअप करना पड़ता है, राइट? सो यू ऑल्सो हैव टू बर्न लाइक अ सन, कि आपने बहुत ज़्यादा प्रैक्टिस कर लिया, देन यू कैन बी अ गुड ग्रेट प्रोग्रामर, राइट? एंड वॉट इज द राइट टाइम टू स्टार्ट, ठीक है? तो कुछ लोग सोचते हैं सेकेंड ईयर में करेंगे, चलो थर्ड ईयर में करेंगे. नहीं, दिस इज द राइट टाइम, राइट? तो द अर्ली यू स्टार्ट द बेटर इट इज, ठीक है? तो जिन्होंने 11 12th में किया है उनके लिए अच्छा है, बट जिन्होंने नहीं किया 11 12th में, उनके लिए दिस इज द राइट टाइम. की छुट्टियां हैं, 2 महीने में आप 11 12th का पूरा सिलेबस खत्म कर सकते हो C++ और जावा का, राइट? तो द अर्ली यू स्टार्ट द बेटर इट इज. एंड कुछ लोगों के दिमाग में ये भी क्वेश्चन होता है कि भैया कॉलेज में फर्स्ट ईयर के मार्क्स मैटर करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे. तो बहुत सारे कॉलेजेस में प्लेसमेंट के टाइम पे ये मार्क्स मैटर करते हैं. तो आपकी जब एवरेज CGPA या एवरेज स्कोर देखा जाता है, देन यू हैव टू बी इन टॉप, लेट्स से 20% ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स और टॉप 25% ऑफ. तो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप शुरू से ही, अब फर्स्ट ईयर में जा रहे हो तो अपनी मार्क्स मेंटेन करके रखो, ठीक है? एंड बहुत ज़्यादा आप अपना टाइम वेस्ट मत करना. एंड बहुत सारे लोगों ने मेरे से ये भी क्वेश्चन पुट अप किया था कि भैया NSUT में CSAI लूँ या COE लूँ या DTU में ये लूँ. तो इसके लिए वी आर डूइंग वन मोर वेबिनार. आज थोड़ा सा टाइम कम है, एंड द गुड थिंग इज कि मुन्ना भैया भी आ रहे हैं. सो मुन्ना भैया ही विल बी बैक इन इंडिया सून, एंड ही इज़ द फाउंडर ऑफ BMC एंड कोडिंग ब्लॉक्स. एंड जो भी आपके दिमाग में क्वेश्चन है जो आप मुन्ना भैया से पूछना चाहते हो, कि जैसे कि इस ब्रांच में नहीं जाना, इस ब्रांच में जाना है, या मुन्ना भैया से कोडिंग के बारे में कुछ पूछना है, तो प्लीज रजिस्टर योर क्वेश्चंस एट दिस लिंक एंड आई एंड मुन्ना भैया विल बी देयर बैक अगेन. जो क्वेश्चन आज अनआंसर्ड रह गए हैं, एंड टी शर्ट्स की भी अनाउंसमेंट करनी थी, वो भी वी विल डू ऑन 14th of June, राइट? तो उससे पहले कोई वेबिनार होगा, आई विल डेफिनेटली कीप यू अपडेटेड. बट आप ये लिंक पर रजिस्ट्रेशन कर दो, एंड आई होप आपको आज थोड़ा सा कोडिंग के बारे में आइडिया मिला होगा, राइट? And that's all for today from my side. So thank you guys. I will see you in the next webinar. Thanks a lot. And if you have any queries, you can also reach me at Prateek@codingblocks.com. Right? So this is nothing. This is my email. Right? So bye-bye. Take care and good night.